Hi, guys. Hey, see you again. Nice to see you.
Very nice to see you.
It's good seeing you.
You too.
We really want to say thank you to the Air Force for having us out. It's been such a great honor for TABS.
We really want you to understand how much this means to us and how much of a milestone this is. I mean, a few years ago, I don't think something like this would even have been possible.
Well, I think the feeling goes both ways. It's been a great experience for the folks here at Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, a great experience for the community.
Well, you know what we did. We listened to the claims of activity in the different buildings. There was Building 70 and the Arnold House. You took us on a tour, you showed us the hot spots, and we set up in each one of those locations covering it to try to see if we're able to catch any of the experiences that people have had.
So, Building 70. That's where you work.
That's right.
And I'm sure that's what you're most curious about.
I'm definitely curious. I'm not sure which way I want this to go.
And we broke into different teams. We covered different areas. We headed into the warehouse area. And while we were in there, we did numerous times see the shadow figure. We caught it at the end of the warehouse. When we were at one end, we were looking down, and this thing had a tendency to walk in front and block out the light. While you were down at one end. Now, I headed down to that area, and I stood there motionless, and Grant stayed down at the other end. And Grant was still able to see this thing and block out the light. But in front of me,
you didn't see anything.
I couldn't see anything.
Which means that obviously it was between where he was standing and I was standing, because it was blocking the light for me, but not for him.
Wow.
Yeah. We had been asking questions and stuff, you know, asking it to show itself.
We were asking it throughout the night to give us knocks in response to a lot of the questions.
You know, we were hearing sounds that didn't make sense. They weren't from our guys, they weren't from us.
Wow.
I actually think
Can I move my desk?
I was
going to
say, I don't work in that building. That's a good thing.
But we do have a recording of the knocking,
okay.
Just so you can hear what we heard. So.
And we know there was nobody else around the building.
Nobody else.
It's coming in 3, 2, 1.
It sounds like it's in the distance. How far away was it? Did it sound like it was coming from
down where we were actually seeing the shadows.
Really? Wow.
So we got is some potential interaction here, which fits the stories that people had mentioned. I don't think there's any threat at all. Nothing to be worried about. Mm-hmm. It's not like anyone's going to get hurt. So as you're working there, you know, you might hear something you don't expect, but that's probably be the extent of it.
Now moving on to the Arnold House, a great little house. It's the original building that was here long before the base.
That's correct.
And you took us for a tour through there, and a lot of the claims were everything from the candlesticks turning over by themselves, people hearing footsteps, doors opening and closing again, shadows walking by doorways. But now a couple of our other investigators, Chris Gartland and Chris Williams, were investigating. And they were actually sitting in the dining room of the house. And they heard what to them sounded like a woman laughing. And
really?
There were no women around.
Well, they were the only two women that were there.
At one point, we were up on the very top floor. And we decided to start trying to ask questions to see if anything was there, if it would answer us. For about 10 minutes straight, we did get responses to our questions.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
And it got progressively more apparent. I mean, I was sitting in one area in the room next to me. It sounded like somebody hit a cardboard box. And then at another point, it sounded like somebody punched a plastic bag full of clothes or whatever was in there.
So not a timid reaction, really, at that point.
No, not at all. And the bathroom door had a tendency to start closing by itself as well. What we decided to do was we decided to take a flashlight. You know the flashlights that you can push the button on the bottom?
Yeah. Right.
We laid the flashlight, and it was off, on the floor in the bathroom. And we asked if anything was there. We explained how to use the flashlight. You push the back, and please to, you know, come up and try it out. Push the flashlight.
Please. We're working together here.
Oh my gosh.
There it goes.
Oh gosh, wow.
To be sitting there, not doing anything, and then to only come on after we've asked it.
That's pretty amazing.
Wow.
How does that make you feel about the Arnold House?
I think I'll stay in Building 70.
That's amazing. Do you think there's more than one thing at the Arnold House? I noticed that was kind of a line of questioning that you were...
Not to startle you at all, but when we were asking for yes and no's...
Yes, and to knock to stop at the number of how many there were.
So And we were able to get the five before we got a knock. So is that true? I don't know.
All right, so the final question I've got is, from in your professional opinion, is Wright-Patterson Air Force Base haunted?
I would say that you guys built the base around a haunted house.
We're going to have to change our maps.
Well, we really want to say thank you.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure. Absolute pleasure.
Thank you.
I gotta tell you, I'm somewhat amazed. They have certainly made me think more about the fact that there could be some folks here on base who really kind of want to communicate with the rest of us.
What HAPS has captured goes along with what people here on the base have claimed to experience. They have been so professional, so great to work with, and we're really excited about what they found.
We're done here, but before we head home, we want to take Steve over to one of the flight simulators, see if he can conquer his fear of flying.
And now you're the pilot of a Wright B 1911 airplane.
Hit the bus, Steve. Hit the bus.
Now pull back with your elevator. Now if you want to make some turns, you've got some room to maneuver with.
I can get us out of this.
Crash! See what I'm saying, guys? Every time a plane goes up, it comes right down.
It was really nice of them to let me get in there and use the simulator and see. It's really fun, but really, it doesn't help me in the slightest. I may even be worse off knowing how we started flying.